Rocks are hard. Brilliant observation, I know. But if you've ever crumbled some mica or broken open a geode, you might have noticed that some rocks are harder than others. And as it turns out, scientists have got a measurement for that. The Mohs hardness scale ranks the hardness of stones. The higher the number, the harder the stone. All the way up to 10, which is diamonds. So a stone that's an 8 on the scale, like topaz, must be pretty tough, right? Well, it turns out there's some underlying nuance to the Mohs scale, and topaz just happens to be the perfect mineral to highlight as we unpack all of that. So grab your pickaxes and let's dig in. So you may have heard of this thing called the Mohs hardness scale, which is used to rank minerals. And on the Mohs scale, every mineral falls somewhere between 1 and 10. Minerals ranked lower on the scale can be scratched by ones higher up on the scale. And some common non-mineral objects get scores too, like fingernails and nails, which is helpful when you're trying to identify minerals out in the field. No need to carry around an array of minerals to have a scratch off. So for example, fingernails have a Mohs hardness of about 2.5, which means you can scratch any mineral ranked below 2.5 with your fingernail. For example, talc and gypsum are both softer than 2.5, which means that any geologist can just pick up a mystery rock and get a sense of what mineral it might be based on whether you can nick it with your fingernail. It's not really working on this one. Now, at the very top of the Mohs scale is diamond, with a score of 10. Diamonds can't be scratched by any naturally occurring mineral, except for other diamonds. At number 9, we have corundum, a hard mineral that's better known as ruby when red, or sapphire when blue. But for more on sapphires, check out our very first Rocks Box video. And right at number 8 on the scale, we have topaz. There are other minerals at number 8 too, but most versions of the scale have topaz as the reference mineral for 8. She's like the 8 to be. But here's the thing about that. Topaz is actually easier to break than a lot of the other 8s, and it's even easier to break than some things that are way lower on the scale. So what's up with that? Well, let's start with a bit of info on topaz in general. Topaz is a silicate mineral, kind of like quartz, but with aluminum and fluorine in the mix too. And topaz's hardness comes from the strong chemical bonds between those atoms, which makes it resistant to being scratched. Pure topaz is completely colorless, but when trace impurities get added into the mix, the resulting crystal can be any number of colors. The most common ones are pale blue and golden yellow, while the rarest topaz colors are red and pink. And these crystals can be truly massive. The largest faceted gemstone in the world is actually a topaz. It's called the El Dorado topaz, and the raw crystal was discovered in Brazil. This stone weighs in at a massive 6.2 kilograms, or 31,000 carats. But while topaz is a pretty gemstone, it's not as tough as the other 8s on the Mohs hardness scale. For instance, there's a stone called beryl that typically ranks about 7.5 to 8, which means it's supposed to be a bit softer than topaz. But beryl tends to be a lot more durable than topaz. And the reason for that is that hardness isn't the only property a stone can have related to its durability. There's also cleavage, and topaz happens to have perfect cleavage. But get your mind out of the gutter, all right? Cleavage is a real geology term. Cleavage is a property related to how crystals break, or cleave, along certain lines. Minerals with strong cleavage break along predictable and well-defined planes. And there are different types of cleavage, and they all vary depending on the internal structure of the crystal. Basically, the way atoms are arranged defines fracture lines, and when a force strikes a crystal, the crystal tends to break along those lines. It's kind of like those chocolate oranges that you need to smack to break apart. The slices are pretty hard, but the entire structure has weak points. When you strike those weak points, the whole thing just falls apart. The atoms in topaz are strongly adhered in certain directions, but only weakly attached in others, leaving weak points. So all you need to do is smack it at the right angle and it'll crack. There are a few different kinds of cleavage too, all based on where the weak points are arranged inside that crystal. And some crystals can even have more than one plane of cleavage in the same crystal. For instance, having two planes is called prismatic cleavage, and three is called cubic cleavage. But there are a lot of others, and we don't have time to go into them all. But because topaz has perfect cleavage, it breaks easily along a bunch of different planes, creating nice defined lines, with both sides having an almost mirror-like sheen. But the Mohs scale doesn't take cleavage into account, because it just characterizes one type of crystal hardness, which is scratch resistance. But scratch hardness is different from other types of hardness. For example, in lab settings, researchers also often want to quantify a mineral's indentation hardness, or its resistance to deformation. In those tests, instead of scratching, they look at how well a mineral holds up to pressure. A sharp tip gets pressed into the surface of the material, and researchers measure how much the tip digs in. Indentation hardness and Mohs hardness usually go together, but not always. In fact, under indentation hardness testing, topaz barely holds up better than quartz, which has a Mohs hardness of 7. And while topaz will scratch a steel file, the steel holds up to indentation testing way better than topaz does. So when you're evaluating a mineral, it's important to consider all of its material properties and keep the Mohs scale in the right context. That shouldn't be too hard, should it? And hey, if you want to give this a try for yourself, you could sign up for a SciShow Rocks Box subscription and receive your own topaz to scratch, squeeze, or just to admire. Every month, our Rocks Box subscribers will get a sample of a mineral or fossil that we handpicked just for you. And they're always ethically sourced, so there's no guilt involved in expanding your collection. But the spots do sell out fast, so head over to scishow.rocks now if you're interested in that subscription. And thanks for watching.